Hello. In the last class, we noticed the orgel diagram for D1, D6, D4 and D9 octahedral and tetrahedral grid. Here, we noticed the orgel diagram for D2, D3, D7, D8 octahedral and tetrahedral grid. Here, we can see that for D2, D3, D7, D8 configuration, the lower energy terms F and P terms are taken. We know that F term are split up into 3, T1G, T2G and T1G from P. P is split into only 1. F is split up into 3, that is T1G, T2G, A2G. And here we can see that there is a crossing occurs because these two terms are different, so it can interact and a crossing occurs. Here we can see that these two terms are same, but from F and this from P, but because of repulsion they never cross each other, but there is some sort of curve occurs in this line, and this is the orgel diagram for D3, D8 octahedral and D2, D7 tetrahedral complexes. And this is the orgel diagram of D2, D7 octahedral and D3, D8 tetrahedral complexes. And in the last class, we see that for the transition of D1, D4 and D6, D9 configuration, we can see that only one type of transition, that is only one DD transition. And in this case we can see that three types of transition occurs, that is from A2G to T2G, then A2G to T1G of P, and A2G to T1G of F. That is three types of transition occurs. And here also three types of transition occurs. That is, the three spectral lines occur in this transitions. And next is in the last class we also discussed that sometimes we can see that only two spectral lines instead of three because of small intensity. At higher frequency, the intensity will become smaller. In the strong field region, there are some sort of allowed and forbidden transition take place. So the intensity become smaller at higher frequency. So instead of three lines, we occur only two lines. That is the reason. And the next is Rake parameter. Rake parameter is the energy of each term of a configuration can be expressed theoretically in terms of equation by choosing three parameters A, B and C. A is arbitrary parameter, B is the repulsive energy difference between two terms of same multiplicity, C is the repulsive energy difference between the two terms of different multiplicity. Using A, B, C value, we can formulate an equation for the energy of each term of a configuration. These parameters are called Rake parameters. And that is here these terms, energy of terms can be calculated using Rake parameters. That is, A, B and C are the Rake parameters. So some sort of equations are written for this energy calculation. These are like this. Then we should note that the energy in each the energy difference between a free ion in ground state F term and an excited P term of same spin multiplicity should be 15. That is the note that we should note it. that is the energy difference between a free ion in ground state F term and an excited P term of the same spin multiplicity is 15 B. That is, in this we can see that 3F and 3P, that is the lowest energy term of same multiplicity. Then only according to the selection rule, transition occurs in these two terms. So these two terms, the energy difference between these two terms should always 15 B. Then next is nucleosynthetic effect. Nucleosynthetic effect is an important question for your exam. Normally the electron repulsion is found to be weaker in complexes than in free ion. Normally electron repulsion is found to be weaker in complexes than in free metal ion. Free metal ion nekalum electron repulsion koravayirikum complexes, because of the delocalization of electron over the ligand, which is away from the metal. That is, that electron should always away from the metal, and which separates the electrons and hence reduces repulsion. That is, because of delocalization of electron over the ligands, which always away from the metal, that means that electrons always away from the metal, and which separates the electron separates the electrons and hence reduces repulsion between the electrons. So the B value in complexes is less than in free metal ion. The reduction of B value from its free ion is normally reported in terms of nucleosynthetic effect, that is the nucleosynthetic ratio, that is beta is equal to B value of complex, that is indicated as B dash, and the B value of free ion, and this value should always less than 1. That is the main condition. This beta is called nucleosynthetic ratio and is also referred to as electron cloud expansion, and this value beta value should always less than 1. And we should know the nucleosynthetic, remember the nucleosynthetic series, that is useful for your CSIR exam. That is soft ligands, that is I minus, Br minus, Cl minus, Cn minus, the order, that is the increasing order of B value. These are soft ligands and these are hard ligands, and the increasing value of B value, we can say that the increasing order of nucleosynthetic series. Increasing order of nucleosynthetic series is like this, and so these are soft ligands, these are hard ligands, and here we can see that soft ligand has covalency will be greater, then the B value become lesser. That is, soft ligand shows more covalency and they show the B value only lesser amount. Thank you.